Right?
Check, check.
Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Looks pretty Gucci.
Show me what to do.
What to do, what to do. Mm-hmm. Dude, this morning, I darted awake at 5 fucking... It was like 5:11. Mm-hmm. I don't know why it was so early. Mm-hmm. And I was wide awake. I'm pretty sure it was because I passed out pretty early too, but... I just ended up watching The Witcher because the season 2 came out today. I don't know if we've talked about this before. I feel like I've asked you. You haven't seen the first Witcher, right?
Nope.
Okay.
Nope.
Have you played any of the video games?
I'm familiar with the stories.
Yeah.
Marginally, but I'm not really into them.
Right.
Weirdly enough, because it's right up my alley.
Yeah. The shows are better than the games. Like,
have you played the games?
Yeah, I played all 3 of them. Yeah, they're pretty good games. I mean,
they're hard.
Really
all
hard.
3 of them are hard.
But I think that's kind of why I liked them, because like I was beating everything at the time I was playing those games. So I was like, all right, this is a good challenge. Yeah, show's really good. I only watched 3 episodes before. They're like hour-long episodes, so it took most of my morning up. So yeah, that was a weird way to wake up. You ever darted awake like that?
Yeah, you know, a lot, actually. Right?
Mm-hmm. I don't know why it happens. Like, I don't know. I haven't done it drinking in a while. It was weird that I drank last night and then shot awake. Usually it's a slow burn, you know.
It's like a cold finger in the ass, bro, waking right up.
Yeah.
I know. Sometimes I'll wake up and right away I'm like, oh, it's time to work, and I'll just get up, you know. It's like when you look at your clock and you're late and you know you're late, and like, I don't have time to fuck around.
Right.
You just get up right away, dude.
Yeah.
And start your day.
That's such a shitty feeling.
Such a shitty feeling.
You're like, fuck, I have 10 minutes. You're just like up and you run and start doing everything.
Yeah, you brush. It's like the quickest you'll ever get ready, dude.
Yeah.
Because how long do you take to get ready in the morning? How early do you wake up for work?
30 well,
minutes, 20 minutes, hour?
I won't go through my whole routine, but I actually wake up like 2 hours early because I work out and shit in the morning now.
That's right. You're telling me that. That's
yeah.
Right.
It's a new regimen I'm doing, and I'm fucking loving it. But I do wake up pretty early, but I'd say it takes me like 20 minutes.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
On average?
On average. The days that I have to shave and shit, it's a little longer. But I got like the electric toothbrush and shit, dude. I got the whole setup in there. So yeah. What about you?
I need an hour.
An hour.
A legit hour.
Yeah.
I mean, I can pull it together in 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes if I really have to. But an hour prep, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
If I work at 10, I'm waking up at 8, you know, 8:30.
Yeah.
And I'm taking my morning real slow.
Right.
One step at a time.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, I guess like I do kind of slowly prep getting ready while I'm working out. Like in between sets, I'll like just put shit out and start setting shit up. So
the morning jerk too, it takes up a lot of time.
Yeah. I feel like you kind of have to have –
that's my workout.
You have to have something in mind, right? Because like if you don't and then you just end up searching for a long time, you're going to get late and shit. So
yeah, yeah. You know that's also happened to me. Been late to shit because of the morning jerk. Takes too long.
I don't know if I've been late because of it.
I
but
definitely have. 100%.
100%. No way I haven't. That's pretty hilarious, actually. Mm-hmm. I didn't think that – wow.
Because it's like you're really invested at that point, and it's like I have to leave in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
But I also am way too far gone. I need to
finish
this job.
If you don't, you might have a bad morning type of thing.
Yeah, definitely. you're bricked up the whole way there, dude.
Right.
You know,
if
you're
starting.
Yeah, it's rough.
Yeah.
Sometimes, speaking of that, and I can say this from experience.
Okay.
Sometimes you need to bust one out at work, bro.
Oh no.
Sometimes you just need to
I didn't know if that's where you were going.
You knew it?
A little bit. Yeah, I had a hunch. Yeah.
Sometimes you just gotta, you know, if all goes wrong.
Yeah.
If all else fails.
I mean, sometimes you just gotta do it in public, dude. Like
sometimes you just gotta, you know,
you ever jerk
on your
off
porch.
Like, in your car.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have to.
Big time.
That's fucked up, dude.
Big time, dude. Yeah.
Hanging
out with a girl that nothing happens with, and then I'm all blue balled. Can't wait the 20-minute drive home. Have to bust one out.
Yeah.
Literally.
I've woken up after a party once, and a girl was, like, trying to fuck, and she was, like, still shit-faced, and I was uncomfortable because of it. So I was like, nope, I'm going in the car. I'm cool. I'm going home. And then I was like, all right.
Quick jerk, might as well.
Yeah. Just get it out of my system. Right. We're starting off really exposing ourselves.
Fuck it. Who cares?
Yeah. All right. Let's listen to Dr. Dre and Eminem's new song called Gospel. We'll have a quick little minute about it after. Yeah. Yeah. What? What?
Yeah.
Dre, you ready?
Ooh.
Come on.
Yo, we gotta all right. Check. Cut him undercover. Timeless. Ready for him. Progress. Feeling like I'm just getting started. Two shots back for my dearly departed. You are now dealing with a monster. Oh shit. Profits. Dr. Dre, bitch, I'm a prophet. Black Wall Street, niggas know where the stock is. Try me. Niggas never see me, but it ain't hard to find me. Unwinding, shit's blinding. Still grinding, uprising. Stop talking about the past, I'm the future.
Die.
Just fade out.
Literally, just not even, bro. It just wants it to die. Yeah. That was a great ending.
That was a great song, dude. Dr. Dre and Eminem and D.O.C. It's called The Gospel, or just Gospel, and he put out a five or something, it's a few songs, EP, because in GTA 5, he's the new expansion. You get a contract from Dr. Dre, it's called GTA 5 Contract.
Really?
It's a new online expansion, he made an EP for it. And the songs are crazy, dude.
Damn.
He has one with Snoop and Busta. Fire, dude.
No shit, really?
Yeah. I was like, dude, Dre's like 60. And he's putting out bangers,
dude. It's 2021. It's about to be 2022. And we're getting Dre drops right now.
Yeah.
I'll fucking take it.
That was a great song,
thankful.
Man.
I am thankful. It's a holiday season and we're fucking.
Right.
We're back.
What do you categorize as like Christmas music? Like, do you actually think it has to be like kind of like poppy Christmas carols?
Yeah, pop.
Things? Okay.
Pop.
Yeah.
Easy. Easy.
Oh, I've heard of artists like rappers, R&B artists and rappers trying to put out Christmas shit. And I was like, I don't know if it fits with
I've heard some artists. Good stuff. I actually don't. I don't hate Christmas music. I just hate when it's replayed over and over and over.
Right.
I mean,
right.
I hear enough Mariah Carey to, you know, turn me into Mariah Carey.
Mariah Carey is one of the ones where.
Notorious.
And it gets old, though. I mean.
This could be the new Christmas song. I'd be down with that.
I would too, yeah.
Uncensored.
You know, Hobson put out a fire fucking Christmas track.
I haven't heard of Hobson in years.
Yeah, it was like 2 or 3 years ago, but he put out a fire one. Oh, okay. It's like, you know the ding, 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 ding. He made that into a beat.
Word.
And it's fire.
He's still relevant? He's still doing stuff?
No idea.
Probably not.
Haven't seen him in a while.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Kind of fell off.
Did.
A lot of those guys fall off.
A lot
Watsky.
Of them. Yeah.
Remember Watsky?
I do remember Watsky.
Yeah.
G-mo Ski. There's a lot of old school cats, though. Vinny Paz.
I don't know who that one is.
Yeah. You ever heard of Jedi Mind Tricks back in the day?
Mm-mm.
Oh, my God. I loved them, but they did. They were known for saying a lot of nonsense in songs, but it sounded really good, you know.
Word.
Yeah.
Word.
But, yeah, Dr. Dre, Eminem, good song. Listen to that EP.
Mm-hmm.
Good shit.
Mm-hmm.
Haven't heard a lot of good music recently. Endorse.
Yeah, that was good. That was good.
I was excited.
We'll drop a little intro. When is this episode going to drop? Is it going to be
on the 23rd? Wednesday, so the 22nd, I think, because then Thursday.
Okay.
Friday's Christmas Eve. So the 22nd, yeah, happy, merry Christmas. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Yep.
From us.
From us.
To you.
To you.
Yeah.
Yes.
We hope it's good. Spend it with your family.
Merry Christmas, Splich.
No.
Merry Christmas.
Shit, dude.
Merry Christmas.
It's condoms.
Open your gifts.
It's really small condoms. Did you really get me something, dude?
I did, yeah.
Open Thank you, bro. I'm so sorry I'm not as thoughtful as you are.
Oh, no, it's cool.
I wish I were.
I probably could have like just told you. Like, I threw this shit on the
floor. This is exciting.
What, the
little this little tin.
Yeah.
This is infinite potential here. You know, this could be anything.
Yeah.
I like how it's wrapped. Did you wrap this shit?
No, yeah, it came like
Can
that.
I just open this?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh.
I didn't know if you were doing it.
I didn't have slowly. To break everything. I destroyed it.
Yeah, I mean, it's yours now. So,
I'm going to say it's something ridiculous. But let's see. I hope it's condoms. It's condoms,
it's
dude.
It's condoms.
I don't even fit in magnums. Oh. So I don't know what I'm going to do with these.
Sorry, bro. I had faith.
Yeah, thanks, bro.
I'm not going to lie. I did not buy that present for you. I went to a Yankee swap last night. At my Christmas party. And
you're really going to give this to me, dude?
Yeah, it's a $25.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
I'll use this for work. Thank you.
Yeah, go ahead.
You got me a gift card for
it's a gas station card.
Gas station card.
Yeah, I thought about it. I was like, oh, I'll throw this on because today's Christmassy.
It's Christmassy vibes.
Yeah.
What I got for you, I got you my presents.
Yeah.
That's all I got as a present. I'm sorry.
That's enough.
It's a pretty shitty.
Oh, that's good.
Shitty present. What is this episode?
Oh, shit. That was supposed to be an applause.
What episode is this? Like 75?
75, yes. The semi-season finale.
Kind of, sort of.
We're going to get swifty this episode.
Do you think... Yeah, I did. I was looking at it earlier. It's actually pretty dope. I like it.
Yeah. What do you think?
Do you think anyone's ever going to look back on these episodes?
No.
You know, like when people like put out content for 2 years.
Yeah.
And then they don't pop until that third year. And then they get a million views. And then you look back at their older videos and they got a good amount of views. Just because like people went back and watched them. You know what I mean?
Okay.
You think that'll ever happen here? Probably not. Maybe.
I don't know.
That'd be interesting.
That would be interesting. Yeah. I'm thinking about it now, just kind of going to a deep dive in my head. I feel like if that was ever going to be the case.
That'd be great.
It'd probably be a family member, though. It'd be someone like.
Oh.
You know?
Yeah, you think they're going to bury us at some point? Probably.
Oh, that'd be awesome. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of content here. So if anyone wants to dig through looking for dirt, I mean, you're looking for hours.
There's going to be so much dirt.
There's a lot of dirt.
Yeah.
There's a lot of dirt.
Well, this is 75 episodes that are at least 1 hour.
And we're morons on all of them.
Some of them are two, and we say a lot of
dumb shit.
Fucked up shit. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, it'll be pretty easy, actually.
Yeah, I think so.
We're very cancelable.
Yeah, for sure. I don't think we've set ourselves up for success.
Yeah.
Oh, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Let me take a sip of this because my throat's dying. Always Sunny. Did you see any of the new season?
I saw clips. I haven't peeped any of the new season, however.
So fucking good now, dude.
It looks good.
It's amazing now.
I saw a clip where Charlie was trying to convince Mac that he was Irish.
Yeah.
It was pretty funny. I was like, oh, that's good.
Yes. Yeah.
That's good shit.
It's
and like Frank is like, what did Frank do in one of the recent episodes? Help me out. He did something. He like supplied somebody with something. He like funded a group, right?
Yeah. I think he does that a lot, but he did. I'm trying to think now.
I don't remember who it was. It was fucked up.
Yeah, I mean, I watched them very quickly because they're only 20 minutes, you know, so I've only seen all of them once so far, but...
Well, that's the thing with Always Sunny, you got to watch them like twice.
Yeah, I probably should, but dude, for something,
at
like,
least twice.
After episode 2, it just got amazing. It got phenomenal.
I feel like they had to get their message out of the way.
Yeah, I was hoping that was the case, and I'm glad it's paying off, because you should definitely watch it.
For sure, yeah, definitely. I absolutely will. Absolutely will. I've been vibing this last week, man. Yeah. I haven't been watching any TV.
Nice.
My vibe is getting home, throwing on a candle, putting the lights real dim, because I have like lights I can control, and then listening to corridos. Do you know what corridos are?
Something you put on while you masturbate?
No, that's a napkin.
Yeah, okay.
No, corridos are, I don't want to say they're specifically Mexican, but they're very Mexican. But they're like Mexican, Guatemalan, Spanish depressing music.
Oh, okay.
So it's about like, my heart got broken and I'm so sad.
Okay.
And I just want to die.
Okay.
And
you know, you made this sound really pleasant at the start.
No, it's not pleasant. It's really fun, but it's great. It's,
so you've been having a
vibe.
A rough week?
No. It's been a great week.
You're enjoying it.
I'm enjoying it. I'm loving it. I'm not even sad while I listen to the music. The song's like, ay, 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 ay.
Okay.
And then the car goes, and ding, 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 ding. And then it starts talking, in memoriam, mi alma. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Shit like that.
Sure.
You know?
Okay.
But it's not, I'm not sad about it. Like, yeah. I listen to it and it's just a vibe. I've been vibing really hard lately. Just relax.
Right.
Keeping my blood pressure low. My heart rate low.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well, that's good though. I feel like anytime you can like not look at screens a shit ton, or me, I guess you were always looking at screens, but not watching TV a shit ton.
Mm.
It's like, I don't know, makes you feel more productive.
Yeah. No, we're always looking at screens that now.
Because you're like in the moment, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
I love it.
Definitely, you know?
Yeah.
It's like 2 a.m, just hanging out by myself. I love it. You know, it's precious. I definitely, I appreciate it.
Do you ever put on music when you masturbate?
No.
I don't think I ever
put on the TV, maybe. Like to have a background noise.
I do too, yeah. There has to be something that's funny. There has to be something playing in the background.
No, it has to be. I can do it in silence.
It depends for me. I mean, if I'm just sitting here in my living room, that's going to be different, you know? I'd probably want to put something on TV. I don't think I'd jerk off in here, though. I did have sex in here, but...
Yeah, that's nice. That's reassuring.
Yeah, it's worse.
My manager, actually funny that we are saying this, my manager admitted to me that he masturbates in the shower. My manager, my boss.
That's weird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's like, yeah, I jerk off in the shower. I'm like, in the fucking shower, dude? I'm like, that's messy.
Yeah. No, it's not.
You take a hot shower, you masturbate, the semen, like, it, like, it's, like, gooey. It sticks to everything, bro. You ever masturbate in the shower?
Not a long time, to be honest.
Yeah, not a long time either, because it's a fucking nightmare.
It's been years.
I haven't done it in literally, like, a long time.
Yeah.
You know, like, maybe 10 years. Yeah. Because it's such a mess. Dude, when you're taking a hot shower.
I wouldn't think, though. I would think the opposite.
You would think the opposite, but when you're taking a hot shower, the hot water, like, breaks it down. And it just gets goopy everywhere. And, dude, it has, like, a texture to it, bro.
Yeah.
It does.
Are you sure it's not what you're consuming?
Oh, 1,000,000%, bro.
Oh, that's that. Okay, that's making it worse.
No. It's not. I'm saying it's not what I'm consuming.
Oh, it's not what you're consuming normal. At all. Okay. Yeah. I thought you said, like, yeah, it's 100% what I'm consuming.
No, what am I consuming?
That's why I was asking. I was like, what would you
eat? Straight gelatin?
Been eating Jell-O and pudding the last week.
What you get when you come in the shower and it's hot water,
why are we talking about this?
It's so gross. It gets everywhere. And then it's hard to go down the drain. Like, it like coagulates, you know what I mean? And I'm not the only one saying this. Like Ethan, Ethan on H3. What?
I think you just have thick cum.
Should I have to be insulted about that? Should I be insulted?
I don't know. Guys think that's a good thing.
Guys think that.
Yeah, Tom Segura likes his big, thick, white loads.
Well, he doesn't say that he comes thick. He says that he comes volume-wise, it's a large amount.
I mean, he probably was joking, but I've heard him say the thick, hot, white. That's what he was saying.
Okay.
I was like, all right.
I get it, I guess. Either way, what I'm trying to say is masturbating in the shower is messy. Yeah. As far as I can remember, and I call my manager out.
I almost want to test this theory.
You should.
I really think I might. Get the water real hot. Yeah.
Masturbate.
We'll recap this next week. Yeah. I'm very curious.
I'm not going to do it because I know it's a mess.
I honestly just figured it would just be easier to clean, to be honest. No, you wouldn't have to do any cleaning because it washes off.
I was telling him, I'm like, that's a nightmare. He's like, no, here's what I do. He's like, I masturbate, I finish near the drain, and then I get my shower thing. And he like hoses it down.
Oh my God. Okay.
I'm like, that's a process.
That is a process. Yeah.
I'm like, he's like, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm doing it in a fucking paper towel. Dude.
Yeah. Right.
A napkin.
There's a lot of other options.
There's a lot of other options.
Go right
man.
Into the trash, toilet. You could do so many different things.
Yeah, like, dude. It's fucking.
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah. Masturbating in the shower, messy. You would think it's clean. It's actually the opposite.
Yeah.
And it's not great. You're like standing.
So much for monetizing this first 15-10 minutes.
Wait, we don't monetize shit, bro.
We're never going to
be
able
to. Are you
making
money? How much money are you making on this?
I'm pretty sure we've made like a couple cents. Like,
really? Yeah. Have we made like $5 yet?
No.
We haven't made $5?
No. Okay. Yeah. Well, if we include like Patreon and like merch and all that, maybe
then no.
we've
then
gotten.
Still no.
Yeah, we've gotten a few. Like, okay. It's probably a couple hundred. I'd say probably 200 or so, maybe 300. But
really?
Yeah, but monetization from like strictly the podcast, it's like 17 cents. Like, it's crazy how low it is. Yeah.
All right. Well, you heard it here. Let your friends and family know. Let your mom know.
Yeah.
That this is like your dad.
Yeah.
Your grandfather. I hear grandfathers really like this podcast.
Yeah.
So let your entire family know that we exist and that we have a podcast. And it's not good. That's my preface. It's not good.
Yeah. And it's satire. It's pretty aggressive joke. So it's probably going to be hard, tough taste. But
Yeah.
If you, speaking of which, let's just keep this going. Did you have a name for your dick?
I did, man. Growing up, kind of, sort of.
I guess I should say, like, did girls have a name or guys have a name for your
No,
dick?
I think that's a little much. I don't have a name for my dick.
I've had a girlfriend, in fact, that had some names for my dick.
Yeah?
Plural, yeah.
Plural?
Multiple names, yeah.
Want to hit me with one of them?
I mean, she went with the classic Squirtle once, but I feel like all girls Squirtle. Do that as a joke. Word. Yeah, because it sounds hilarious. Mm-hmm. One of them was Mark. Thought that was pretty fishy. I was like, who's Mark?
I used to have, when I was a kid in middle school, I used to have this one really long hair that was almost as long as my dick, dude. Like, really long, bro. Like,
that's
inches.
Good. Yeah.
Right?
Wow.
And I called the hair Jimmy.
Nice. Hammer was another one, too, and she just thought it was really funny.
The hammer? Yeah. You give him the hammer?
So, wait a minute. How long do your pubes get now?
Not very long.
Okay. That hasn't happened like
No. That was like one hair. Before I had any hairs.
Okay.
I had like the one really long hair. And it was so weird. And I let it grow because I was like, this is awesome.
Yeah, like, this is cool. I've never seen this before.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I feel like I've had probably one or two of those on my nuts before.
Yeah.
Like, especially got to the, when I was younger.
It got to the point where it would tuck itself into my dick.
Yeah.
That ever happened to you?
The hair?
Yeah, yeah. You
ever like get, it goes all the way up and then...
And down. Not like down the urethra. I mean like down the foreskin.
No.
Yeah.
I don't think that's ever happened to me.
I don't know if it's happened to me.
No.
No.
I mean,
and then I cut it
probably
off.
During sex, but not like me. Like I haven't noticed it personally. But yeah. If your dick could talk, what would it sound like? What would it say? Or if it just made noises, what noise would it make?
Ooh, baby.
Yeah.
That's We're going to get some tonight.
Why do you give it a high-pitched voice? That actually would be so funny.
Ooh-wee. It sounds like Miss Amici's.
Yeah.
Wow. We're going to get some.
Ooh-wee.
Okay, yeah. Ooh-wee.
Yeah. That would be great, actually. Every time you took your dick out. What would vagina sound like?
You're like, you're talking to a girl, and it's like, what about me? What about me?
Vaginas are just like, whoa.
They'd have really deep voices. Like, come here, sugar. Let me see what that thing do.
Yeah, like an old Italian woman or an old black woman. She's like, yeah.
I could, you're doing two fingers, I could take three. Yeah, you know what I mean? It'd sound like that.
Yikes.
Pussies would sound like they smoked three packs a day.
Yeah, like the kid, the lung thing. The lung cancer thing.
I need a smoke.
Right, right. Isn't that, what is that, SpongeBob?
What?
Isn't there a lady like that in SpongeBob? Like an iconic one?
Chocolate!
Is that? That's They're what I'm thinking
chocolate.
Of.
Okay.
Yeah. So it sounded like that, basically.
Yeah, it sounded like
the
that.
Vagina kinda. Would.
Yeah, what do you think a vagina would say?
Feed me.
I'm hungry.
Feed me.
Feed me.
Feed me.
It's hard as balls.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you think they make... What if they made fun of you? What if they're just like, that's
Oh, they
it?
Would, they would, they would. Yeah.
That's all you got?
That's the shrimp.
Like while you're fighting them?
That's the hammer.
Is it in yet?
Is it in yet? Yeah, dude, seriously.
Oh, my God.
With a mouth half full. Is it in yet?
Oh, man, what if you're trying to hook up with That'd a girl and then your dick's like, ew, what's that? What's that smell? Like,
yeah. Ooh, wee. Oh, shit. No, I don't want that. Oh, dude.
Oh, no.
I'd be like, buddy, shut the fuck up. Yeah. We're going in, dude. Shh. He's like, I don't want to.
There would definitely be a lot more.
That'd be hilarious, dude.
Mutilations of genitalia.
There'd you think so? Be,
yes. Yeah.
No, you think they'd cut them off?
I'd cut my
I
dick
think
off.
I
think I'd cut my dick off.
I think movies would never be the same. I think, you know, cop partner dramas would be a man and his penis, and they're both cops.
Yeah. Right.
And like, you know, a romance is where a man falls in love with his penis.
Okay.
Or a woman learns to love her vagina.
Dude, there'd probably be shows of penises and vaginas where the cameras are just on the penises and vaginas.
Yeah, you know there would probably be like conversations between people and then would pan to a conversation between their genitalia.
Right.
So it'd go to their groins and it'd zoom in and they'd talk to each other.
Yeah.
I think that'd be really interesting. It would definitely change entertainment.
It would.
I think Eminem would definitely have an alter ego.
Yeah.
For his dick. What do you think it'd be named? Eminem. Skittles. Yeah, I'm Skittles, bitch.
Skittles. That's actually pretty good.
Coming
I don't think
back
anything...
with the riddles, bitch.
Yeah, and nothing's going to get better than that. Skittles is good. Yeah.
Skittles is good.
That's a good one.
Yeah. I think that's sick.
That's wild.
I like this universe. I hope it exists.
So we have to ask now, what about like boobs and buttholes?
I don't know. At that point,
I think boobs don't have openings, right? So
they nothing. Got, they do. How do you get milk?
But they
out of
shouldn't
them,
like make a vocal sound like penises and vaginas can. You know what I mean?
Boobs can only whistle.
Okay.
Yeah, they.
They just whistle. What about guys' boobs?
Oh, it just sounds like wind.
Like a queef.
Like a queef. That's all. Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly.
All right. And then buttholes?
Buttholes are universal. Everyone has one, so they can't be noisy. Because you already have genitalia that's already pretty
noisy. Oh, all right. When you fart, it just says a word or something.
No,
or...
the butthole is the intake valve. It sucks in all the air for all the other orifices to speak.
Oh.
Right?
So you have like reverse farts.
Mm-hmm.
You just... That's how your genitalia can talk, actually. You have to do a reverse fart first, and then they start speaking.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. So,
this is a good universe.
Yeah.
This is a good universe.
I'm a fan.
I have to name the episode something around that.
You think so?
Yeah. Shouldn't have went that far, I think. Mm. So, that was nice.
All good.
Oh boy. All right. If real life had like one-ups, like Mario, like you can get an extra life if you do something, what would you have to do in order to obtain it? Like the universe grants you an extra life if you do blank. Is it a moral thing? Is it a
feat? That's what I'm trying to think. Is it monetary? Is it moral?
I don't know. Let's explore.
Do you have to give?
Or we can play a few different ones out, you know? Maybe it's breaking world records. You just get a
then everyone life. Would be trying to break world records. Any world
everyone record. Would be trying to do that too. Yeah. Like
that'd
everyone.
Be an interesting world.
Yeah.
Like then every single world record would be respectable.
Yeah.
Hot dog eating contest, fat guys eating hot dogs.
Right.
Respectable. They're athletes. Yeah.
A lot more people would probably die too, like for things like that, or for like the longest like skydive or something. Like there'd be a lot
right,
more like,
right.
You know, there'd be a lot less people here.
Most gasoline ingested most in one setting.
Yeah.
That's a world record.
Someone has the record for 4 minutes and four buckets. 20 people die from it. Oh my God, that'd be horrible.
Yeah, that would be horrible.
Yeah. Okay. So that's one. What about, okay. So we could play out the card of like, if you do good moral shit, but you have to do something really crazy.
Yeah, I like the whole moral thing. If you're a genuine person of character,
right,
at the time of your death, you'll get a and a fucking spinning mushroom will float above your head,
right,
and everyone can see it.
Yeah, right.
And it'd make a really loud noise to everyone in the area, so it like announces it.
Yeah.
And like, oh, someone around here got a life up. Everyone would come running.
Oh, there'd definitely be people waiting for those people and just to kill them again right after. You know what I mean?
Think so?
There definitely
would be. Yeah, there'd be groups of people doing that. That'd be interesting. But like, it would announce it.
Imagine like religious people. They'd be like, no, you're playing with God. And then they'd kill them because they came back type of thing.
Well, it'd also be like the ultimate test of who you are.
Right.
Because imagine you're like the Pope. And when you die, people are like, oh, he's definitely going to get a life up when he dies.
Yeah.
And you're like the first pope in 500 years to not get a life up.
Right, yeah.
It's like that pope was into some fucked up shit, right?
It's like yeah, he fucked my kid.
So yeah, but you would find it like on his deathbed.
Yeah.
Because he wouldn't get a life up.
Right. Everyone's just sitting there like, it's not happening.
right. Yeah. Because otherwise, you'll get your life up way too early and you'd be like, oh, now I'm just going to squander it.
Right.
Okay, I get another one after, so who cares?
Yeah.
What I do in this one, right? I like the whole moral thing.
The moral thing, it seems right. The moral thing is cool. Right? Like, it seems like that's like, if a movie was made, that's probably how it would.
And it announces it to 10,000 people. The closest 10,000 people around you.
Yeah.
No matter what your distance. You can be in the middle of the desert.
Yeah.
It'll announce it to 10,000 people closest to you.
Yeah.
And then amongst those are going to be people that want to steal your life up.
Right. Okay, so what if you can get a life up, right? But then if you do fucked up shit, the universe can like take it away if you're still alive in that life.
Well, that's why I say you get it before you die.
So what if you get it and then you shoot up a school after? Then you have another life? You just kill yourself and then come, you know what I mean?
I mean, I guess. But if you're a person of that moral character and you live your entire life right, why would you do that at the end?
Yeah, I don't know.
That probably wouldn't be
random ass.
You probably wouldn't get a life up at that point.
Right.
You know what I mean? Because you'd probably slip up other places.
No, definitely.
Along your life.
Yeah.
So you probably wouldn't get it.
Accidentally click on the wrong website.
This makes sense. This is like an interesting idea.
Yeah.
I
would like that if the universe actually gifted things to people, but like physically that we can all see and like, I don't know.
We do already, don't you think?
Not physically, I mean, I think.
You know what hit me last night, bro? All right. So I was reading this story. Back in the early 1900s, they came out with this medicine. It was called radon. I think it was just legit called radiation or radon or something like that.
Okay.
But it's a liquid that you ingest, and it's supposed to like be like a common cure-all and cure a bunch of things. But it's radiation is what it is. It's actual radiation.
I've heard of something like this.
Right. So this is one gentleman that was prescribed it for. He like broke his arm and was prescribed this medicine at like teaspoon a day. But he would drink bottles a day. Like he liked the way it tasted. He liked the way it made him feel. It was laced with cocaine.
Right. Okay.
And his jaw, after like a couple weeks, his jaw fell off.
Oh, Jesus.
So there's a picture of this guy with no, like his face is normal up to here. And this is all falling off. And I was thinking, I'm like, dude, that's it. There's no more jaw. His life is fucking done.
Yeah.
No more tasting, no more talking.
That'd be so shitty.
Awful, dude.
What do you do? Would you kill yourself at that point?
Well, there's so many people out there like that, that are born deformed, are in accidents.
Oh, yeah, no. Yeah.
You know, overcome addiction.
I don't know if I could live like that, dude. Not being able to eat.
Like one of those people that are in a horrific accident in kindergarten and lose one of their arms.
Right, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Or like one of those kids that like, I don't know. I don't know.
Yeah.
It's too close to a gunshot and loses his hearing.
Right.
Like that's how life is. You got one chance. And I have all my senses. I have all my limbs.
Yeah. I
got all my pieces and never broken a bone yet.
Have you? I've broken a shit ton. Yeah.
Have you really?
I've fucked up my body. Yeah.
Have you really?
Oh yeah. I have a few cracked ribs. I've broken my right knee, fractured my ankle.
Doing what? Fighting?
Fighting and hockey, dude. And
hockey.
That kind of comes intertwined too. Sometimes fighting and hockey. So yeah.
Fighting and hockey, huh? Hockey
yeah.
is fucking crazy.
Hockey was nuts, dude. I played that shit for like 10 years. So
yeah, I never broke anything, thank goodness. So
yeah,
you know.
No, I broke quite some shit, but I don't know. I agree on like a spiritual level, I guess I could say, but I feel like it would just be really badass if like someone got to like play with like they could like cause lightning at places. They have like Zeus's thunderbolt for a day, you know?
Oh,
what
yeah,
I mean?
That'd
from
be
the
sick,
universe but, they just yeah. reward people with random shit
sometimes. Oh yeah, yeah, I feel you.
Just
yeah.
like cool ass shit.
I feel
you. Guy gets to a certain part in a volcano and it's just like a giant gold ball. You can just like sell it for like $10 billion. I don't know. Random shit.
Yeah. If a stripper gives you a lap dance and she has no arms, is it half off?
I'd want half off. I'd be kind of pissed if she
was like, she has no legs.
Yeah. If she has no legs?
Yeah.
I mean, she's not going to be able to get the money from me, so.
You know what I mean? She has arms.
Oh, okay, so she has no legs but arms in the scenario? Yeah. I'd still take half off, yeah. She could be all creepy.
I'd give her double the money.
Really?
I'd double that shit.
No. I'm good. That'd be scary. You wouldn't be frightened. I know it's a poor choice of words and it sounds horrible.
Be scared?
But
why would I be scared?
I'm just thinking a girl coming up with nubs.
Yeah.
And her tits out.
Yeah, bro. But if she's, fuck it. Give me that lap dance. I'm taking it.
I'd get freaked out. I'd have to experience it a few times before I can then pay and shit. I'd get freaked out as fuck in the first few times, dude.
I'd be the first one to pay. I'd be like, whoa, dude.
Yeah.
I'd be into it.
So, if someone, she has to still have I know this is going to sound fucked up.
Of course she has a vagina.
Okay,
dude.
So she has like,
of course she has a,
it's yeah, like down to the like waist here. And then, yeah, so she can still like grind on you and you're just going to feel the nubs on the side of it. You know what I mean? Wouldn't that freak you out?
No, it's not nubs. I mean, she has booty, bro. It's like her booty fell off. She's got no legs.
Okay, just like, yeah, the end of the booty down.
It's going to feel like you're getting a normal lap dance.
I don't think
legs.
So, man.
There are no legs.
I think you're going to feel a little something on like the, and you're going to be like,
yeah, fuck
why
it.
Are we exploring this? I don't know. It sounds funny.
I think it's discount lap
discount
dance,
city.
And I'm taking it. I'm taking it.
Yeah.
I'm hip.
All right. If you're in a relationship, right? You're in there for like 5-10 years.
Right. Oh, a long time.
A long time. Marrying this girl.
And she loses her shit?
Well, that was my next one.
What did she lose?
Think of it. But hold on. I'll just ask this one first because I had this beforehand, but I will.
You fuck.
You're going to get married, right?
Sure.
For her bachelorette party, she's inviting a dancing bear. Is that what they're called? The stripper?
Sure.
Do you accept it? Are you okay with it?
I mean, yeah.
He's the one that like fucks everyone, like on all the porn videos.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, I don't want to get fucked.
Like, I'm pretty sure it's like he's going to go there slinging dick around. And.
Well, I mean, you know.
Yeah.
If I'm going to marry her, I'll probably trust her. So,
yeah.
I mean.
Yeah.
I'll be like, please don't fuck him.
Yeah.
Or the wedding's off.
What would your rebuttal to that be, though? Because I know I'm going to be like.
Then I'm going to get a stripper, too. What the fuck?
Right. Like,
I'm
going to
mega lab dances.
I'm
going to
get one that's like, I'm pretty much just going to buy an escort because.
You're going to get an escort?
We're touching and shit.
For real?
No, but the boys, if they're getting dicks in their face and in the mouth,
then we need
something.
Oh, you think they're getting dicks in the mouth, dude?
Yeah, dude.
You think that's what happens?
You got to watch one of those videos. It's wild. Like, they're just like regular. I mean, obviously for the porn,
yeah,
it's scripted. Yeah, but I'm saying like that shit happens when like a stripper will go to a party and the girls like will get drunk or something and then just start fucking them. And like,
sure.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
I don't know. That's kind of what you expect. That level of
I mean,
I guess, man.
Yeah, so that's why
you're,
I was like,
you're triggering my insecurity right now. I'm not even gonna lie. Just yeah, no, at that point I'd be like, yeah, please don't.
Yeah, that's why I'm getting an escort.
Fuck so. The guy. Yeah, I probably wouldn't. Yeah.
No, I wouldn't be there. Yeah. All right. You're gonna marry your wife after 10 years and she loses the legs.
Easy access to the pussy, bro.
Yeah.
Emergency you guys access, are like, dare I say.
You guys are like 35, so you still have a long life ahead of you.
Dare I say, easy access, bro.
Nice. That's gross. Turn to it. I probably would too, honestly. 10 years is a long time.
Yeah, 10 years is a long time.
What if it's like 2 or 3 years? Like,
plus, I'm not out here like trying to hike mountains and shit. So like, who cares? Yeah. Maybe when I'm 35, who knows?
I actually don't really see that much of a downside of a girl not having legs. I think it would just get rough, like if she really liked going on walks and shit.
Yeah.
You know, she's like, let's go to the beach. You're like, okay.
You can even still drive like that. They make hand pedals.
Right. You know, and like the wheelchairs and shit they have now, they're probably going to have prosthetic legs pretty soon, like just available to the public, you know?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, for sure, dude.
Yeah, so.
They definitely do.
Yeah.
They got a robot. That's actually kind of hot. You fuck a bitch with robot appendages. All robot.
I feel like I'd need
arms, legs, robot.
I need a little bit of human.
No,
I need a
no human, bro.
No.
The pussy's human.
You're just, okay. Well, no, that's still a bit much.
Torso, head, human. Everything else, prosthetic.
Honestly, we probably won't be able to tell the difference eventually.
Rack them up. Yeah, but right now, it looks like it's cold, hard steel.
Yeah, and you can like see it, feel it, touch it.
Touch it.
Literally like.
When she goes.
Makes noises. Oh, boy.
Yeah.
The noise has kind of taken down a notch for me. Is it like the whole, like all those noises too? Just like mad, obnoxious. And when
when she's walking backwards, it goes beep, beep.
When she's just walking.
Beep, yeah.
She's like, oh, I see that in the store right there? Beep, beep, beep. Going back to it. That'd be a bit much.
And she kind of walks like a robot.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, I guess I'd probably have sex with almost anything, to be honest.
But, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, creatures. Last week's episode.
Yeah.
Don't matter proved what anything.
It is. I'll fuck that banana. Don't get me started.
That banana had a real life anatomically correct pussy. Warm, everything.
No.
Yes.
No.
That's God's
gift. I think it would have
God
to be.
Gives you this fucking banana.
That's like a giant.
I have to get it now.
A fleshlight. Yeah. I mean, they know Barney, but yeah, I get it. For the listeners, it's just a giant stuffed banana named Barney.
Listen.
He's a Rasta, but
I am almost convinced that you would keep this shit hidden. This would be like your little secret. What? An anatomically correct pussy, bro.
That I could have sex with?
Oh, yeah.
Dude, I'm not trying to fuck that bad.
You probably would.
I don't know.
You would smash this thing.
I'd have to be like.
You would have this thing, bro. This thing would be like. And you'd be like, damn, bro. And you're like, yeah, in the ass. It's not.
It'd be so funny.
Yeah, dude. And you're like, damn, that shit's just looking at me right now, bro.
I'd actually get kind of grossed out, to be honest.
You have to shave it, dude. Like, gross hair, dude.
It grows a little fucking like fur, like banana fur.
Yeah.
Exactly. No, would you?
Would I? Oh, yeah. If you're not doing it, I'm fucking doing it. I'm taking
it. Yeah, no, I don't think I would. I don't even want to
call him Barney, though.
I feel like getting a fleshlight is weird, dude.
You never had a fleshlight?
No, I've never fucked anything besides for a human.
Oh, dude, the first time it came on this podcast, the first time, Tosta asked me how many sex toys I had.
Oh, yeah.
Remember that?
Yes, yeah. That was a while ago.
That
Jesus.
Was a long time
ago.
That was
like 40 episodes, 50 episodes.
That was that was January 2021.
Yeah, that's probably like episode
31. Dude, we're closing out the year 2021. This has been a year of podcasting.
Yeah.
This has been a legit year of podcasting.
Right, because then next week will be our season finale too. So then that'll be the last one of the year. So legitimately a year of podcasting.
Dude, fucking get it here,
yeah,
dude.
That was fucking... We did it.
We did it, bro. It's a fucking year of putting out content.
I don't think we've made any progress since last year. I think
we made a little.
This time last year, we were probably about the same boat.
Really?
Might have one or two more people, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, shout out to Dean from Australia. That's like, you know what I mean? I don't remember many other names. There was a few of them, but sorry, guys.
It's all good.
Yeah. Call into the podcast, 603-922-4074.
Yeah, dude. Just
shit on, yeah.
Seriously, right? Your podcast, man.
Yeah. I had something else to go off of on that. What were we just talking about? Oh, prosthetic pussies and people and shit.
Sure.
What about, like, what if, like, in the future, you think they'll have, like, oh, my dog died. or my dog got its legs ripped off. Can you give it prosthetic doggy legs? And there's little robot doggies running around. I don't see why not.
Yeah. I mean, dogs already have like those wheelchair things.
Yeah.
Like if they lose their back legs, they have little wheels for the back too.
Yeah. Those things are hilarious looking.
Yeah. They're so fucking cute.
Yeah. They are cute. Yeah.
Dogs are amazing. I see a lot of dogs in my line of work and I love it.
Yeah.
I absolutely love dogs.
That is one thing that like I feel like unconditionally I'll immediately assume every dog I meet is like the most precious thing in the world. Like dogs have to prove me wrong before they have to prove me right.
You know right. I agree. People have to prove you right.
Whereas dogs have to
prove you wrong before you like them. You know what I mean? Totally agree with you. I actually saw this dog recently this week where the homeowner is like, oh, yeah, he's a fucking loudmouth. I don't want to get him out of his cage. He gets really jumpy. I'm like, I love dogs. If you don't want to keep him caged up for the next hour and a half, you
yeah,
don't know. Like,
right.
I guarantee he's not going to bite me.
Yeah.
She goes like, are you sure? Are you sure? I'm like, yeah, I'm fucking great with dogs. Bought him out. But you got to introduce yourself the right way, bro.
Yeah, no, 100%.
You can't just shove your hand in their face, which is what fucking people do.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah. No, you're right. I did not mean to hit the...
Thanks,
that actually dude. Sounds offensive now.
That yeah, did not what mean the to hit fuck, that. Dude?
Yeah.
That hurt my feelings.
All right. We're going to do Christmas trivia game.
Oh, no.
You know how bad we're going to be at this? I'm not a big Christmas guy, are you?
I'm a family guy. I'm not a big Christmas guy,
however. Okay, yeah.
If that makes sense.
No, it does, yeah. Okay, we'll start this now. Who was the star in the Christmas movie Jingle All the Way?
Christmas trivia!
That's a nice intro.
Thanks. Hey,
should I put some reverb and shit on that?
Bow, bow, bow. Yeah, a little the trumpets. Yeah. So the question was, who was the star of the Christmas movie Jingle All the Way? Yeah,
I know this.
I have no fucking idea.
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
For real?
Yep.
Danny DeVito.
It was Arnold.
Who tries to stop Christmas by coming? By I'd stealing say. All things of Christmas from the Who's? Oh, it's the Grinch.
It has to be the Grinch, but I feel like it would have been a better question if it was who tries to stop the Christmas by coming instead of trying to stop it from coming.
From coming. I said by coming.
Yeah.
From coming.
I think it'd be funnier if like there's a character that just came and just nutted over all the presents and shit. Mm. So
yeah, I think
like an evil
or if someone Grinch. Nutted all over your Christmas presents, would you still open them?
No. Well, with gloves probably actually, yeah.
But you would still.
Yeah, because you'd have to just tear the wrapping off, right?
So, right.
I mean, if they like open them and then nut it all over the item,
yeah, the inside.
That's it. That's end game for me. But
like, why does it smell like fucking cum?
Yeah.
So it's definitely the Grinch.
It's definitely the Grinch.
It's 100%.
No way, it's not the Grinch. Okay.
Come on.
Who is the star of the movie titled White Christmas? Oh God, I have no idea.
Tom Cruise. I don't know.
I'll go with who's the guy who played the Santa Claus guy? Tim Allen?
Oh, no. Ed Asner.
Ted, Ed Asner?
Ed Asner, dude.
Well, Tim Allen or Ed Asner. We'll go with those two. Who the fuck is Bing Crosby?
Facts.
All right. What was the first name of Scrooge, the principal character of the novel Christmas Carol? Ebenezer.
Right? Ebenezer Scrooge, yeah.
I'm pretty positive.
Yeah, I'm with that.
Gang.
Gang.
Who was the author of A Christmas Carol? No fucking idea.
Carol,
okay, good. Mm-hmm. What do you got for last name?
Carol Christmas.
Mrs. Carol Christmas?
No, Carol Christmas.
Yeah, but I had a miss in front of it, so it's Miss Carol Christmas. Miss?
Yes, Miss Carol Christmas.
Okay,
yes.
I'm going with that too.
The third.
Oh, Charles Dickens.
Charles.
I probably shouldn't have known that. How many ghosts are there in A Christmas Carol? God, well, I mean, if we didn't know. I'm going to go with 3. That sounds good.
3 is a good number. I'm going to go with 7.
7? Like it.
Oh, it's definitely 3, though.
4.
4.
Yeah, we were both wrong.
We fucking suck.
What was the name of the animated Christmas movie featuring Tom Hanks? Toy Story.
Well, Grandma got run over by a reindeer. No, I don't know.
8 Crazy Nights.
Let's go with...
Toy Story's not it either, but I know Tom Hanks is in it, so...
Is he really?
Isn't he Woody? I'm pretty sure Tom Hanks is Woody.
Yeah?
Yeah. And Tim Allen is Buzz.
Okay.
Yeah.
Home Alone.
Home Alone?
Yeah.
That's not animated.
Yeah.
What's the one where the kid looks like Claymation? I'm gonna go with that one. And he's like a little like elf hat on and shit, you know. Always Sunny actually made fun of it on their Christmas.
Yeah, episode. They did. Yeah. A lot of shows make fun of it.
Yeah, like whatever that show is. That's my answer.
The Peanuts, Polar Express.
Probably should have known that one too. I'm not a big fan of all these Christmas movies. Have you seen like a lot of these?
Or? Polar Express, I've seen it quite a few times.
Really?
I didn't know Tom Hanks was in it.
Is it a good one? I don't know.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yeah,
it's a pretty good Christmas movie. Yeah,
I feel like agree. I almost watched it in high school, but I passed the fuck out so many times during movies in high school.
So. I had little brothers, man, so I was watching all this baby True. Shit when I came out.
Right.
You know what I mean?
What made Frosty came to life in the movie Frosty the Snowman? Ooh.
Someone put a finger in his butt.
That's definitely the answer. I'm going to go with someone pissed on him.
That's
his hat. Oh, I totally knew that too. Yeah. Why did the other reindeer pick on Rudolph? Because he had a hog, dude. Yeah, he was slinging that shit around.
Totally.
It's common knowledge.
That's very common knowledge. Everyone knows that.
His Rudy red nose. They could have just said red nose. They didn't have to add Rudy in there.
His Rudy red nose.
Right? What does that even mean? Rudy Jules? Bad friends. How many reindeer were in the toy? Were in the story Twas the Night Before Christmas? I have no idea.
What the fuck? 13.
13?
13.
I'm going to say 8. 4 and 4 sounds like a good number to me.
Cool. Yeah. I like that number.
Oh, shit. It was 8.
Oh.
That was a guess.
Fuck. Good job,
All dude. Right. What, maybe 5 more? We'll do the last 5.
Sure, sure.
Who helped Rudolph after he left the North Pole? Santa? I don't know.
Not What's Donald Trump. He doesn't like immigrants.
Yeah, no. It wasn't Trump.
It definitely wasn't Trump. Definitely wasn't Trump.
Jamie Foxx.
Rosa Parks.
Rosa Parks. Good Rosa one. Parks. Good Rosa one. Parks. Oh, I can't look at the TV. It's too delayed. Herney the Elf and Yukon Cornelius.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, I was so close to
Damn,
that
dude.
One.
We were rimming it.
Yeah, we were right there.
What bad guy did Rudolph have to avoid? Santa Claus.
Hans Gruber.
Hans Gruber. Why does that sound familiar?
That's like Die Hard, pretty sure.
I think it is Die Hard. Yeah, yeah. Good memory. The Abominable Snowman. I had no idea. The Abominable Snowman was a reindeer thing. I thought that was like a separate story. Like that had Rudolph.
I don't know. This shit is...
This is wild.
This is wild.
Who played George Bailey in It's a Wonderful Life? So this is just strictly
I don't even know.
Movie Christmas trivia.
I don't even know, bro.
And like stories and shit. So, yeah.
Can I do this next question?
Chet Hanks.
Chet Bailey. Hanks?
Yeah, that's my guess.
Okay, I like that. I'm going to go with that one, Chet Hanks. It's right. Definitely Chet Hanks.
Jimmy Stewart.
Okay. Who spies on kids?
And reports back to Santa?
No, I was just going to stop there. Who spies on kids? That's
kind of a wild
thing. I'm going to say
too.
God.
Okay.
God spies on kids.
Yeah, and Santa's above God.
I'm
going to
say...
He has to report back to Santa.
Kevin Spacey spies on kids.
Definitely. He was definitely one of them.
Definitely one of them.
I might want to say the president, but that might be a cheap
Biden?
Shot.
Biden?
Yeah.
Well, he's weird when it comes to kids.
He's got a little weird kid thing going on.
I don't think it's like I don't want to disrespect. I don't think it's a kid thing. I think he's just weird with kids.
No, yeah, that's what I mean. Like he's got the little weird like turning and smelling. It's like okay.
Yeah, I don't know what that's all about. That's a little
old white people do that though.
Yeah,
other old white people have done that.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. It's not a Biden thing. It's an old white people thing.
Yeah, that's why I said it was a cheap shot.
Yeah, exactly. I totally agree.
I think Kevin Spacey's a really good one. I think
Epstein. Epstein spies.
Epstein was
no,
who I was
Ghislaine
thinking.
No, Ghislaine Maxwell.
Yeah, there we go.
That's who spies on kids and reports back to Santa. All right,
we got it.
That's how Epstein got... Elf on a Shelf.
Oh, I remember that stupid-ass story when I was young. Remember, did your fucking parents ever do any of that shit where they're like,
no, we're Spanish, motherfucker,
okay,
dude.
Yeah, they didn't.
We're Spanish, bro.
I remember my fucking mother telling me that, and I laughed at her. She's like, Santa has an elf on a shelf that watches you, so don't be naughty. And I was like, fuck that thing. Like,
that's
I was like
fucking stupid.
Little 10-year-old.
She tried to tell you that for the first time when you were 12.
Right, yeah.
I'm sure you didn't fall for it.
No, I was probably just starting to act out, you know.
You're like, no,
I was like, good one,
wasn't.
Bitch. Imagine. What toy's magical powers that goes on new adventure every night after the kids go to sleep? That's fucking
Oh,
Toy Story.
The vibrators. Hey, the mom loves that. The magical powers on that one is fucking crazy.
I think that's good.
The Bad Dragon Dildo.
Yep, yep.
That toy goes on adventures every night after the kids go to bed.
Magical powers that goes on a new adventure every night. Oh, the closet that when you go through it, Narnia is on the other side. I'd consider that a toy. You know?
How many... Dude, you know, statistically, you know people who are cucks out there.
Oh, yeah.
Have you met people?
Should I anal something?
What I'm trying to say is like, cause like you went to school with like their parents statistically, like
definitely some cucky shit.
Some fucking cucky shit going on, bro.
That's another one. There's probably some cameras, you know, that just go on at nighttime.
Yep. You know. Definitely agree. You know? The sex swing. The swing gets a lot of usage.
Hit it night, I'm sure. This really does low key sound like fucking Toy Story, and I don't think that's a Christmas thing. Elf on a shelf again.
Come on. This is so fucking stupid. We're done with this. Elf on a fucking shelf.
We're done with this.
I think we dug pretty deep on that one.
That game was ass. That's what that game was.
That was 100%. I feel like that was also targeted towards children.
Definitely, yeah.
On Christmas Eve.
Yeah. I mean, there were some Christmas stories in there too, but it was probably more for younger
audience. For younger adults, yeah. Right. Not younger adults, younger children, younger babies.
Yeah. I watched the movie as it premiered Thursday night, Spider-Man No Way Home.
I want to watch it so fucking bad, dude. I watched it
with Jake and Haley. We went to the movies.
How fucking awesome was it, dude? I heard it was amazing,
dude. If you don't see this fucking movie as soon as you can, dude.
I'm going to see it.
It's the best Marvel movie.
I almost got invited on Thursday. One of my coworkers is like, oh, my husband is going and we have an extra ticket. If you want to go with him, you can.
Right.
But she ended up taking her cousin.
Yeah.
Or he ended up taking his cousin, so they didn't take me.
Right.
But I heard it's really fucking good. I heard they got the other Spider-Mans and they were in there for a good amount of the movie.
I'm not going to say anything, dude. Don't say anything, I'm just going to let you watch it because that movie in the cutscenes. One of the cutscenes, which I low-key want to just show you, or not the cutscenes, the end credits. I want to show you one of the end credit things now. Did you see my Snapchat a few days ago?
No.
The Doctor Strange 2 trailer is at the end.
Can we watch it? Will it spoil?
Yes, we can watch it. No, it has nothing to do with Spider-Man. So they just played this at the end credits, which was dope as fuck to
that's
me.
That's awesome.
But there's a leak of it online. I'm pretty positive it's still here. So
yeah, it's definitely got to be up there.
We're probably going to anal for a second. I'll chop this up. Damn, it was even fucking taken down from this, like, torn website.
Yeah, that really on top
Disney
of it.
Disney was fucking... Can I spoil the trailer for you? Or do you want to wait? It's that big, honestly, that...
I'm kind of excited, bro. If you can't, if you really can't find it, then yeah, spoil it. Is it taken down even here?
Yeah, here too. I think this is back to that same one we were just on.
No.
I can try Pornhub. I've seen a lot of these on Pornhub.
Yeah. Try on Pornhub because that's one place you cannot take shit down. Right. That's about on brand. That's about what we expected, bro.
It definitely would have been one of the top videos. So
100%.
Fuck. Okay, man, I have to spoil the trailer, just the trailer part.
Just hit me with it.
And then I do want to do a really quick thing on Spider-Man after, but...
Cool.
The Doctor Strange 2 trailer. Spoiler alert, if someone who didn't see it and wants to wait and watch it, he does get Wanda. So Wanda is in it.
Wanda Vision?
The Wanda Maximoff. Wanda, Scarlet Witch.
After Chaos Magic.
So the trailer like opens up with him going to find her and she's like, I know I hurt people. He's like, it's not about that. What do you know about the multiverse? And the trailer begins. It's all this crazy shit. And then at the end of the trailer, Wong, you hear him talking, right?
Wong, who's that?
Doctor Strange is like right-hand man, the Asian.
Yeah.
He's like, I don't want to be the one to tell you this, Strange, but the... strongest and most like the most powerful creature in the universe that we can't stop is you. And then it shows Doctor Strange looking at evil Doctor Strange like the fucking What If episode that I watched.
You did watch it then?
I watched it.
How fucking good was that episode?
That trailer made me watch it.
Yeah.
It's exactly like the...
Is it him, though? Is it that version of him?
It's fucking him, dude. And he's dark and evil and has all shit on him and shit. Like, he's literally looking at himself from another reality that lost his shit and, like, decided to be evil.
Yeah.
That's what Doctor Strange 2 is going to be about.
No
shit. I'm so fucking excited for that, dude.
No shit, like, dude.
I'm like...
And it's crazy because in this version of the universe, this is, like, the one universe where Doctor Strange, his girlfriend, didn't die.
Right.
She's still alive.
Louder than
like they're not together, right?
Right.
But she's still alive.
Yeah, and I mean, even in the trailer for the movie, it looks like that she's in it. Rachel McAdams is in it. So she's back in the movie. I don't know what they're going to do, but just the fact that it ended with Wong saying, look, the person we can't stop, the most powerful person in the multiverse is fucking you, Stephen Strange. And then he like looks at himself and he's like, things got a bit out of hand. Like the dark version said that. And I was like, ah!
That's so fucking dope.
I was like, yo.
God.
And then immediately after, I was like, all right, Ruben was talking about this. I got to watch What If right now. And then it just tied it all together for me. I was like, okay.
How did you love that ending where the entire universe crumbles to nothing that's around him?
And he doesn't, like, that's it. And that's the end of everything.
Yeah.
Yeah. I loved it. It was amazing. So
he's like, you're going to spend eternity here by yourself.
Yeah. Yeah. So I do want to just do a really quick recap of Spider-Man because we're going to go on Marvel shit.
Yeah.
And
don't spoil it, but yeah.
Yeah. Somehow that trailer like really caught my, like took my attention.
That's fucking
like,
awesome.
I was like, oh my God. But
so glad they're doing that. Oh, they're doing such a great job.
So I'm not going to spoil anything about Spider-Man No Way Home. I'm just going to say, one, Doctor Strange is not in it as much as you think. In it, from the trailers, it looks like he is like the main character.
But he's not.
He's not.
But
and it's a good thing.
I feel like that's a good thing because really good goes and does his own thing, right?
Yeah.
And they're probably going to talk about that in another movie.
I don't want to tell about what he does or where he goes or anything.
I figure he has to go do something.
It'll definitely spoil
He's like, I'm going to go do this. You do this, Peter. And Peter's like, what?
Yeah, so.
I'm sure that's what happens. So.
Yeah, kind of, I guess. Yeah.
Any other superheroes in it? Reputable?
Like,
don't spoil it, though.
Like not Spider-Man, but in the Marvel universe, Matt Murdock is in it, which I don't remember who he is in the comics, but he's some other big Matt character. Murdock,
who's that?
I can't remember off the top of my head.
Is he in another movie?
Not yet. No.
Oh, so he's like coming up.
Yeah. They definitely put him in there for a reason. Cause when they said the name, that, and the only other thing I'm going to say, it's 2.5 hours and it's worth, it's worth sitting until the last second of the end credit scene.
Word.
I went, and I didn't think, I was like, yeah, no, we're going to go see it on opening night.
Yeah.
So.
Was it packed?
Well, I was like, it's still post-COVID. There can't be that many people going out. Like, how many Marvel fans are around here? Packed, dude. We barely got seats. Like, we were lucky to get a 3-seat in a row. Like, it was that packed.
Holy shit. That's
so awesome. Yeah, we sat in the front, and it was one of those audiences, dude.
Clapping.
As things happened. Yeah, and everyone's screaming.
Freaks
dude.
The
theater erupted, and me, Jake, and Haley are just like,
"That's awesome, though, dude. You can't do that. That's such a great feeling,
man.
Bro.
It was amazing until you couldn't hear the movie. Then it sucked.
Was it that bad?
It was that bad. It was obnoxious at points.
That's rough. Like, that's rough.
I don't mind the cheer.
You were watching with a bunch of kids, is what you're watching. It with.
They were 30 to 40 year olds, some of them 50s, dude. This was grown ass adults.
When did you go?
In PJs, Thursday night, opening night.
So, which theater?
AMC Londonderry. It's like 5 minutes from.
Okay, so you didn't go to the one that I got invited to.
Yeah.
But
I mean, dude, that audience, it literally made those parts actually less impactful for me. Like, I loved it, and then I couldn't hear for like a minute after because there was them calming down.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, Jesus Christ, like. Yeah. And then when we were leaving, fucking Jake and Haley didn't want to stay, and no one left the theater. Every single person stayed in that theater.
Yeah, of course. It's Marvel, like, dude.
So they really
don't believe in Marvel.
Following, dude.
They really fucking do. It's Marvel's insane. Done something incredible, dude.
Yeah. Go watch that movie ASAP.
I'm definitely going to.
Yeah. I'll watch that movie again today. You could say, John, I want to go after this, and I would go. I would.
For real?
I would cancel whatever I'm doing.
What's going on tomorrow? Are we getting snow tomorrow?
Well, I think this is going to go overnight, so it's probably going to be shitty. I don't know if we're going to get more snow. But
I hope we don't get too much, dude.
I don't either. I'm not a fan of snow, to be honest.
It's snowing guaranteed until... Oh, it's snowing all night until 4 or 5 in the morning.
I was going to say, I'm pretty sure tomorrow morning I'm going to have to leave from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. just to fucking... So they can shovel the...
Yeah.
The driveway or the parking lot. But yeah. So yeah, that Spider-Man shit was nuts. Yeah, I was watching Witcher. You have any bingeables? Watch anything? I know you said you weren't watching much TV. But
not watching a lot of TV. YouTube Shorts, fucking amazing. Instagram.
YouTube Shorts are getting fucking good, dude.
They're getting really fucking good.
Really good.
I can watch YouTube shorts for an hour and a half, 2 hours.
I had caught myself doing it for a while the other day. I was like, damn, these are like, they kept me entertained. Like,
they do. They do. My thing with YouTube shorts, dude, we got to get in this YouTube short market.
We do. We actually, there's a lot of things I want to improve on, and I kind of want to make a whole plan for season 4.
Okay.
So when we take like a week off after next week's episode.
So we definitely, we want to take a week off?
Oh, yeah. Okay. I've done that at every season. There's like a 2 week gap.
So we take a break? Okay.
So I'll try to like update, maybe some intro, maybe some outro. I'll try to.
So when the next episode, you want it to be season finale? You want this to be season finale?
No, yeah, we can do next episode because we'll still record next week. And okay. Then, yeah.
We'll bring the heat then. I'll try to bring something fun that we can do.
Yeah.
And talk
try
about.
To get a game.
Right.
Yeah. I do still have.
Let's get some guests next week then.
Some topics and shit.
Try to get like Jake and Haley.
Maybe we should. Yeah. Not a bad idea.
Yeah, definitely.
How much longer do you want to go? We're at an hour.
It's not pretty hard.
I was going to say, you have to drive.
I do have to drive.
I want to keep mine, you know.
Yeah.
Same thing, audience. We're recording while it's the Saturday before you're hearing this, so it's snowing, you know.
Pretty hard, yeah.
Yeah, I think it's probably going to be harder the more north you go, too. You're going to Nashua, so.
Yeah, no biggie. Let's do one more thing and wrap it up.
All right. What are your preference? Because we have a...
Definitely a woman. You know, but if for enough money, I'll give a hand job.
I think I'm there with you. If you were filthy rich, what does your dream house or setup look like? Did we already talk about this? I feel like we already did that one.
If I, my dream house setup, what do you mean?
Like, if you were filthy rich, what's like your ideal house and property?
Oh, somewhere warm, 100%. Yeah. Somewhere warm. I have multiple properties and I just go with the season, somewhere up here, somewhere warm. But I still want to have a house in New England.
Yeah.
Love this area, bro.
I would say.
I really do love this area. I'm really happy that I'm born and raised in New England.
Yeah.
Because this is like. I mean, we are some of the most, this is kind of presumptuous, but we are some of the most educated people in the entire country.
We do it. New England has a very good, like.
Education system.
Yeah.
The MCAS that we take is so much more difficult than any of the more standardized tests in the rest of the country.
Yeah.
You could take a student from Massachusetts, put them anywhere, and they get straight A's.
Yeah. Massachusetts especially, too. There's so many, like, it's like college city. It's the best colleges in the world.
Yeah.
In Boston. Like, never mind all the surrounding cities are great. Like, it's, really good shit up here. But
right, exactly.
Yeah. That's a good one. I like the multiple house thing. I didn't really think about that because I'd probably do something similar.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. But like, I meet enough people that's what rich people do.
Yeah.
Rich people have multiple properties and go to those properties as they see fit. And they leave their furniture, they leave their clothes, and they just have seasonal clothes at those places.
Yeah.
Like,
right.
I meet people that'll have a house here in on the coast of New Hampshire. But like, yeah, I also have a house in Florida, I have a house in California. You know, have a house somewhere tropical. Like, that's what people do.
Yeah, right.
And it's real. I see it all the time.
Yeah. I'd probably do something similar.
That's what I would do.
What about the houses, like one story, two story, three story? What are you doing with them?
I don't know, keeping them. I wouldn't rent them. If I'm filthy rich, I wouldn't worry about renting them out.
No, I mean, like, how big are you buying them? You're filthy rich, so, like, you're buying these houses. You're going to have mansions or you're just going to have houses. You know what I mean?
Yeah, probably just houses,
dude. I'm going to do the same.
Yeah, I'm not really into mansions.
I'll have one two-story house, I think, but I'm going to just have a few other one-story ones with a basement, probably one story with a basement.
I do a lot of house visits, and I visited a lot of houses over the last 4 years, and I can say that the nicest houses are the little ones with a really nice design to them.
Right. Yeah.
The bigger you get, as long as it's one construction, it's great.
Yeah.
There are a lot of houses I see that are add-ons on add-ons on add-ons on add-ons, and they're a fucking nightmare to do anything in.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, yeah.
Yeah.
House on Epstein Island for sure.
Yeah. No, that's, I mean, we have to do it there.
You have to do it there.
Yeah. Oh God. You really, yeah. You got to watch
that's that. What Frank was,
I was going to say, you got to watch the new Always Sunny episodes.
Yeah, Frank was, He's like, I've been to Epstein Island a couple times, you know?
Yeah, he's like, just for the snorkeling.
Just for the snorkeling, yeah, exactly.
All right, we'll end on this. Asa Akira, famous Asian porn star. We've all
nutted. I was like, that sounds mad familiar.
We've all nutted to her at least once.
I'm sure.
She has a child.
All right.
How fucked up do you think that fucks up the child? What do you think? Like,
no.
No?
No, because it's
not
like
today's world.
All right. No, not at all, man, because... With children, it's not trauma unless you frame it up as trauma. Like, if he's like, yeah, listen, son, I do porn. That's what I do from a young age. That's how we pay the bills. That's what your mom does. She's probably not going to do it until she's 80. So I can imagine by the time the kid's a teenager or a young adult, she's probably not going to still be doing porn, but who knows?
Yeah.
Does Asakir still do porn?
I don't think so. No, I think she stopped, actually.
So then, you know, not a big deal, bro.
Yeah. She was on Bobby Lee's podcast a couple of years ago. She mentioned something about stopping because of her kid, you know? Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's to fuck up a kid, like, you gotta.
Well, so
it's all about trauma.
Here's my thought process, right? Kids watch porn. He stumbles across a video and is like, oh my fucking God.
That's my mom. Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, but that I mean, like, if you grow up and that's how the experience is, like, right. You probably just kind of figure it out.
I think, like,
you probably don't masturbate to Asian porn for that reason. There you go. Like, you just don't like Asian porn.
You imagine her saying that. She's like, trust me. Like, I know you're going to get into this stuff. I know kids are talking to you about it. Just look up other stuff. Like,
yeah, you'd have to. You'd have to. 100%.
I feel like she's the type of person to do that, too. If you were upfront with them, yeah, that probably is good. Yeah.
But I mean,
I can imagine that fucking them up.
People are strange, man. Like, I've watched videos of porn stars are like, oh yeah, and this is my husband.
Right.
And the husband's like, he's a character.
Yeah.
You know? And you kind of have to be married to a porn star, right?
Well, yeah, to a degree, I say.
Right. But I don't know. I think that kind of stuff is more or less okay. Like, I was watching an episode of YMH recently, and Tom Segura and Christina were talking about how their kids cuss.
Yeah.
And at the Christmas party, they were like saying fuck and shit and goddamn.
God fucking damn it.
I love that shit.
So funny.
When Tom imitates his youngest son, I crack up because he gives him, him a deep voice.
I don't know why he gives them those voices, but he makes them sound like
they're fucking
like just people.
Like people, like adults. Like real ass people, God dude.
Fucking damn it.
So funny.
Yeah,
dude, when the doorbell rings, God fucking damn.
Right.
But I can imagine people saying, oh my God, your kid said that?
Yeah.
How old is your kid? 2. Oh my God, you're going to raise him to be a nightmare. Like, no. Just because these kids are cussing, like, it doesn't fucking matter.
I was going to say, a lot of that shit is bad parenting. Same thing, like, you keep fucking sweets and treats away from your kids and then they end up getting really fat. Like, that's that mentality. You can't hold them away. Just let, you know, don't treat it like it's anything special. And
yeah.
I don't know. That could definitely fuck someone up. Are you a dominant or a submissive in sex?
I'm mainly dominant. I'll fuck around and I'm fluid though. I'll do whatever we want to do. I've been sub. I've mainly dom though. What about yourself?
I'm straight down the middle. I love both.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I
love being sub.
I gotta say my ex was a great dom when she wanted to be, and it was a lot of fun.
But
she's the only person I've been with that
right.
was capable. Everybody else I've been dom with.
That's actually a good way to describe it. Just a lot of fun. Cause like when they're
good at it.
When they're good at it and they're into it, it's like a real good, intense set.
It's
like
hot.
Real good.
And really
then,
hot.
Yeah. And then obviously when you're dom.
Like I would let an older lady, I haven't had an older lady be dom with me yet, but I would love that. That'd be great.
I don't know if I'd do it with like a MILF, but I would. Yeah.
Definitely. What are you kidding me,
100%.
Dude?
Good point.
Fucking call her mommy.
Right?
It'd be amazing.
I don't know if I could do the whole mommy thing, but
I definitely could, dude.
Maybe if she was like, I could do like a teacher student role play thing. I could do that type of shit.
I could do all of it.
The mommy thing would be a bit.
Dude, the daddy thing, every girl likes to call you daddy now.
Yeah.
Dude, come on. Like, you probably see it all the time.
Well, for me, I think that's just, it's something about it that makes like me saying mommy just sounds gross to me. It makes me feel weird. You know what I mean? So, even if I was in a sexual situation, like if I said it, I'd probably giggle.
I would definitely giggle. Doesn't mean I don't find it hot.
Yeah,
dude,
but I feel like in the middle of, I know.
I'm like, whip out those mommy milkers, bro. Yeah. Whip them out.
Is it, I know you've had the situation where you're like with a girl that, I mean, you've been dating for a little while and you like do or say funny shit during sex.
Mm-hmm.
And like, you're still fucking, but like, you just like accidentally, like you bump heads or something. And you're like, oh fuck, that really hurt.
Laugh it off real quick.
Right.
Like, dude. It's weird, but like real sex is like super casual.
It is so
casual. It's like super you'll do something dumb like, oh, fuck my back. Like, are you okay? Like, I'm fine. Let's go back into it. Like, you know what I mean?
I'd say like that's like the most common sex.
There are
obviously nights where it's just straight passion. There's nights where it's other shit. But yeah, no, that's definitely the most common where it's just.
For sure.
Yeah. What if imagine porn was just like that? All like, porn was just.
Ah, oh, my hip. Yeah. Oh, hold on. I pulled a muscle and like you got to lay down. She's like, oh my God.
That's
okay.
The worst, dude. Pulling a hammy.
A hammy, yeah. Like your hamstring, your fucking calf.
Doing your toes and like, fucking. My toes curl up, dude. And I have to like lean back. I'm like,
me
stop.
Too.
Everything has to stop.
That's a memory I haven't thought of in such a long time.
Unlock that in your head.
Dude, that's happened to me. Like, because you do that, bro. You like point your toes and you curl your shit.
Yeah.
And so hard that like you'll pull your calf.
Dude, it's like painful.
And it's pain. And I go, like, stop. I go, stop, yeah. stop. Right. And she's like, you okay? I'm like, no.
And half the time,
I've been
in those situations where the girl got kind of like, because like I almost like it took like the momentum out of it.
Yeah.
And she was just like, fuck. And I was like, I'm sorry. Like this just happens. Like,
yeah.
I've had someone get pissed, but.
Really?
Yeah.
Just go back into it. Who fucking cares?
Well, it was a bit hard to after that.
Oh, really?
Because of it was a weird scenario. It was like fighting sex. It was like angry. Like we were kind of in an argument. And it wasn't a good argument.
Okay.
And we kind of had sex. And then after, like, it was just like.
The baggage came out.
Now we're thinking about it again.
Yeah, that's tough.
Yeah.
I've been there, done that, bro. Been there, done that. But, hey, so-and-so is life, bro.
Yeah. This was the semi-finale. This is the 24th. Episode of season 3, episode 75 altogether. That's wild that we do this.
Yeah, that we're that far.
Yeah. So I want to say this. I want to do like a YMH live type thing.
Okay.
I don't know if we're going to actually do it live, but we're going to do...
Ooh, heavy.
A heavy,
hell
dark,
yeah.
Dark, fucked up podcast.
Let's do it, bro.
No censoring. Yep. No, and we're gonna show like
nudity,
murder videos, death. Porn.
Yeah,
it's all gonna be showing.
Unshine.
But I'm gonna upload it as like a video on my personal website because my website allows me to be its own streaming service.
Word.
So there's no censorship. I could literally post anything I want on there, and I could post someone like getting beheaded and. No one can take it down.
Let's fucking do it.
You know?
Let's
so do it. I'm going to record one of those and I want to release them to people for like $5. Just see if someone will buy them. You have to get it on the website. And if you pay for it, you can watch it forever.
Word.
You know?
You want to charge for it though?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. It's going to be like Patreon.
Because otherwise it's not going to get any traction. It's going to be super heavy.
Yeah.
So it's not like you can post it anywhere else.
And either. I was going to say, I'm not going to post some real fucked up shit like that. Just so anyone can watch it. I want it to have like a fail safe. Like, no, you have to pay to even see this fucked up content.
Let's do it because I have a vacation come up. I'll get drunk.
Oh, fuck, dude.
I'll get drunk.
That'll be wild.
I'll get drunk.
Yeah.
I'll
just give you one drink and just be like, Ruben, drink this over the next hour so that we can.
Yeah. So can,
yeah.
No, I'll fucking shots.
Because I'll pregame, you know.
I'll pregame too.
All right. Okay.
Let's fucking do it.
Yeah. If you want to drink. Yeah.
Let's do it. Yeah. This
will be a good time. Fucking crash here if you need it or Uber, whatever you need, you know.
Yeah. For sure.
All right. Yeah. We'll do it. All right. So be on the lookout for that because I'm very serious about this. That's something I wanted to do on the 2 weeks off, just like fucking around, like have some friends over and be like, all right, let's record some. Horrible, twisted, dark shit.
We'll make an announcement. We'll record it. We'll throw it up. I love it.
Yeah.
I'm with it, bro. Absolutely. Gang.
All right. Call into the podcast. Text us. Leave a comment. Tell us what to talk about. If you have any topics or anything you want us to bring up. If you want to send in some foul shit, we'll repeat it. 603-922-4074. BrootalView@gmail.com. That's BROOTAL. I never specify that.
Yeah,
Brutal View is not spelled brutal.
Brutal
View.
Yeah,
it's
BROOTAL.
I wonder how many emails that email address has gotten.
Very few.
Probably like two, right?
Two.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll see you guys next week. Thanks for tuning in.
See y'all later.